All right, everyone. So this is what the finished product looks like of my Seaside Aquatics fish trap that I got, or quarantine system, you can call it, whatever you want. I don't know. It's going to work for both for me is what I'm going to use it for, fish trap and whatever. So that's kind of what the finished product looks like, just to show you. So you guys can see what's up. So it kind of hooks onto the side like that, as you can see. And I didn't use the, it does come with extra screws that you can use right here to kind of brace it onto your rim of your aquarium. The only reason I didn't need to do that is because my rim is really thick. So that's the reason why I didn't need to do that at all. It was kind of a waste. So if you have a thinner rim, or if you just want to brace it a little bit better, you could put it on. But I don't think my fish are going to mind that this is on a slant. See how it's on a slant a little bit compared to being straight? I don't think the fish are going to mind and not go in there because of it's on a slant. At least I hope not, because then that'll stink, because that's the only way that I'm trying to get them out of the fish tank and do that. So the fish I am trying to get out, just to let you know, on this adventure are my damsels. I'm not trying to get all them out. I'm trying to get maybe one or two out. I'm thinking maybe just get one out for now and drop them off at the pet store, the biggest one, or, you know, whichever one I can get is what I'm thinking about. So I'm going to try to get him out. So this is kind of like a little test, and I'm not going to get them out right now this second. I watched some videos, and you should really, you know, put it in there, acclimate them a little bit, get them used to it, and then put the food in for a couple days. Let them go in there with the food, see what's up, and then you trap them after that. Make it easier on yourself. If you want to be aggressive about it and you want to get them out, then you can do something else, but I don't know if it'll work. This is the approach I'm taking, just to show you guys my approach on what I'm doing. So that's pretty much what it is, and that's what I'm going with. And that's the damselfish are the ones that I'm trying to trap and take out of the tank, because I wanted to put other fish in here, and they seem to be more territorial than the other fish. So the only fish that really goes up to it all the time is my cardinal fish, which there she is right there, Denise, I guess you can call her for now. That is the cardinal fish, and she goes right up to it, and I don't know if she's naive, or she's just absent-minded, she just doesn't care, I don't know, or she's brave. I don't think it's because she's brave, I think she's just absent-minded and doesn't really care. So, but she goes right up to it, and she's probably going to be the first one in there, but we'll see. I'm going to do a little bit of an example. We're going to throw some food in there and see if it works. I turned off my pumps already. Make sure you turn off your pumps. My pumps are in feeding mode, so this way it's not blowing around the food outside of that box. So, because the point is to make the fish go into the box, not to have them, you know what I mean, travel outside of it. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to put the food in there right now. And this is just, like I said, a little review to see how it's going to work on your first day. And it might take a couple tries. So let's get this done. All right, everybody, I ran out of frozen food that I usually chop in half or in quarters, because I do not give my fish the entire amount of food. That is a waste, and it makes a big bio load for the tank, so it doesn't make sense. So give me a minute, I'll be right back, and I'll start filming in a second as soon as I get this food out, and let me cut it in squares. So I usually cut enough for like 2-3 weeks. So let me just cut some up and get this going, all right? Thank you. Hello, everyone. We are back with Glen Velvet Reviews, and this is just an updated video on the fish trap that I got, the Seaside Aquatics fish trap that I got. That's on the left over there, as you can see it right here. I got the medium-sized one, and this is a 40-gallon breeder, so you guys have an idea of what you're dealing with in size and stuff like that, so you can see it compared to my 40-gallon breeder. And we're gonna, yesterday I stuck some food in there, but I had to go out, so I didn't get to see what happened. So this is the second day I'm getting the fish used to it. I'm gonna have them get used to it for a while before I try to trap them in there. It seems pretty easy, but I'm not in a rush to get them out this second, because I'm gonna order more fish, but I wanna get my damsels out, those blue damsels. I wanna get one or two of them out, maybe only have one in there, maybe two, maybe just one, but I'm looking to take them out. They're a little aggressive and they get a little territorial, you know, and so I'm not really a fan of that. So I'm looking to get rid of them at some point, not this second, because like I said, I'm waiting to see what kind of fish I should get next and what's up. So let's put the fish food in here and see how they react. Like I said, I'm trying to get them used to it, so you're going to see it how I'm seeing it, because yesterday I had to go out and I didn't see what went on. I came back and the food was all gone, so I have no idea what happened. So now you're going to see how it goes and see how they go in there. I do not have the door on yet. I didn't put the door on because I did not see a necessity to put the door on right now. Because I'm just having them get used to it and go in it. And then, like I said, I'm probably going to trap the blue ones and get them out at some point. But you could see how, you're going to see how simple it is. And this is the second day, and see if they go in there and they eat. And then you could see how easy it is and how great this little contraption works for you. Okay? So let's grab some food and let's throw it in. So I got my frozen food. We're just going to throw it inside the little container right there. There's the container right there that they're going to eat out of. So I threw it in there already. And that's the little, that's the tube right there, as you could see. And the little red gasket that helps keep it up in the air. So I put that in there. They should smell that and they're going to go to it and you're going to watch it. I'm probably going to speed up the video, obviously, because I don't know how long it's going to take. And I don't want to make this a 20-minute video of you guys just watching the fish. So I'm going to be speeding this up in the next couple of seconds. But, next couple of minute or whatever you don't call it. So we're going to do that and that's it. So let's see how they react and see if they go. And I already threw the food in there. It is floating at the top because it didn't drop yet. So it's still floating. Usually you want to turn off your power heads though. I did not turn off the power heads. Make sure you turn off your power heads because I'm going to turn mine off right now and put them in feeding mode. Okay, now it's in feeding mode. So I put my power heads in feeding mode. Make sure to do that because otherwise the water is going to blow through those holes in there and it's going to blow the food right out. And then you're not going to be trapping anything. They're just going to wait for the food to come out. Okay? So that's pretty much what you're seeing right now and what's going on. Alright, so that was just a little review. Like I said, they're all in there. You could see how easy it is to trap everybody. They're all going in there and fucking around and playing games. And they're all messing around and going in there and I poke at it. And there we go. There's the other one. I wanted him to eat. That's what I wanted. I wanted to make sure my pajama cardinal was eating. Because he's not really that big of an eater. So now he's eating, now I feel a lot better. Whoa, everybody out. So, that's it. You see how simple it is. So they all went in there, they all ate. This is the second day, they all got used to it, they're good to go. And that's it. They're all gonna... I can trap pretty much all of them if I wanted to at one point, and then net them back in. So that was a little review from Glen Velvet, and to see if this works out for you. Hopefully it does, and you can see if this kind of system will work out for you in trapping your fish out of the reef aquarium. I don't have any corals. I know I can't really call it a reef because I don't have corals yet, but still with the live rock, it's very tough to get fish out of here. So, you know, that's all I'm saying. So, that's it. If you have any questions or comments, make sure to post them down below. I would love to know. Also, please subscribe. And join me on my review adventure of everything else that I like to review and all this other products and stuff, just to try to help you guys out, make a decision if it's going to be right for you or not and working in your application. And thanks for watching. Have a good one. Glen Velvet Reviews is out. Bye-bye, everybody. Be safe.